Hi everyone, welcome to In the Car 9. It's me Praveen and with me is Jayanth.
Hi.
It's been quite some time that we recorded the video, Jayanth, because we were traveling together and
traveling apart.
Yeah, so it was hard to, you know, sit together in the car and record something. So yeah. Sorry for that. But today is, I would not say it's, generally I say it's interesting, right? But today it's more fundamental.
Feeling hungry.
Yeah, exactly. So it's about food. It's about the purpose on, you know, why we want to eat food, and you know how food as a thing is changing from how we ate food to how we are trying to do, you know, eat food today, and multiple things like that. It's all because of the invent of new things, new technology, and things like that, right?
Yeah.
So how are people in the world today, you know, perceiving food?
Yeah.
So I was recently looking at few things. It was basically a video on YouTube, Jayanth, like we record. Somebody had recorded that, you know, they were not having food for like some 35 days or something.
Okay.
Instead, they had something called Soylent.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, you know, they basically, Soylent is a drink.
Mm-hmm.
It has probably got the right mixture of all the, you know, proteins and magnesium and whatever required for your body. I think it's got the right mixture.
Mm-hmm.
So what he did is to try and not to have food,
mm-hmm.
but only have Soylent for 35 days.
Okay.
And it was really interesting for me to understand that, you know, can somebody actually try and do something like that?
Mm-hmm.
Because I always crave for food. And that was the exact point which he mentioned, telling, you know, food, he was asking the purpose of, is it for taste or is it for survival that you eat food?
Yeah, do you live to eat or do you eat to live?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, he basically concluded after, you know, drinking Soylent for like, you know, 30, 35 plus days.
Yeah.
He said it is, his body changes were absolutely minimal.
Yeah.
He was absolutely fine, energetic, no fatigue, nothing. The only thing which he felt sad was the taste part of it.
Yeah.
So we as people are so much used to the taste side of things, of food, that we most of the time ignore the nutrients which are coming along.
Exactly.
You know, we want to go, let's say, have a pizza.
Yeah.
Because it tastes better for us to our tongue, right? So we kind of always suffice our tongue and not our body.
Correct.
Fully.
Correct.
So Soylent is one of the companies which are doing such kind of things.
I remember about Soylent, it was a pretty huge movement that had happened, I think about 3-4 years ago.
Yes.
Where mostly in the Bay Area, a lot of people started consuming Soylent, but for some strange reason it failed. I see now why it failed, because as you are saying, it is, people crave for the flavor and not for nutrition or for health.
Yeah.
Which is obvious. If we look at it from a perspective of what is important for anybody today is not nutritious food. Just today morning, incidentally, I was reading, the government of India has directed FSSAI,
mm-hmm.
saying that you should put large red labels on food, saying this contains high salt or this contains high sugar or this contains high fats or
correct.
Whatever.
Correct.
So it is just to make people aware that this is something that is there. Now, it is still your choice to consume.
Correct.
So, just because something gets nutritious, people are not going to consume it.
Yeah.
But the problem, or rather the good thing about Soylent was it was engineered food.
Yeah, it is an engineered food, yes.
It is not naturally grown or anything.
Correct.
So, it had the optimal levels of, let's say, nutrition in it. I don't know if viewers, you remember that we had spoken about engineering food back in our hydroponics video, wherein we said there is a possibility of giving the right kind of ingredients right at the stage of growing. You can grow lettuce with more magnesium or more whatever, and engineer it in a certain way. But this is extreme level of engineering.
Correct.
There are other forms of extreme levels of engineering that is starting or started rather.
Mm-hmm.
Things like, say for example, lab grown food.
Mm.
Which is, just to give an example of that, the lab-grown meat is becoming very popular.
So you mean you're not going to slaughter animals, but you grow
animals.
Meat.
Yes, you put cells together in such a way that, you know, it tastes like meat, it is meat, but at the same time, it is not slaughtered.
So this was the one which got really famous in the Mobile World Conference, right?
Yeah, recently? In CES.
Yeah.
This year, it got very famous. It's called
as
an impossible burger.
Yeah.
Just because it is lab-grown meat. But the concept of what you said, that nutrition is important as well as the flavor and the smell and everything is important, is becoming more and more now.
Correct.
So, say for example, the kitchens of Baskin-Robbins or the kitchens of McDonald's are striving to do that by keeping still the prices low. So they are engineering food now that it can feed masses if necessary. But still, the value of nutrition is still preserved in their food. This is something very surprising. If you go into US, most of the times, you'll see that a McDonald's burger is cheaper than a head of cauliflower or broccoli or whatever.
Exactly.
So people are not buying agriculture produced food, but are buying food which is getting generated in large kitchens.
Oh, okay. So, which is kind of grown in large kitchens or engineered, like you said, in large kitchens, right?
Exactly.
It's like manufacturing food.
It's manufacturing food.
Yeah?
Yes. Absolutely.
Oh man, you're not growing food, but you're manufacturing food now.
Yeah. And what is going to happen over a period of time is actually our generation or the next generation is not going to be used to eating grown food.
Fresh vegetables and probably.
Exactly. Because at the end of the day, as long as you get your nutrition.
Exactly.
How you get your nutrition doesn't matter.
And I saw somebody from Berlin also was trying an experiment on himself who said, I'm going to consume like 20 plus tablets.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Yeah.
He doesn't have food, breakfast. I mean, he doesn't have food. No breakfast, no lunch, no dinner, nothing.
Shucks, okay.
He only takes 25 tablets in a day.
Yeah.
And that's it. And he is hale and healthy. That's what he says. Because for me, for him, the consumption of food is about having the right nutrition. And he says, if these tablets can give me all these nutrients, why should I even, bother about... the food which is grown, and also be concerned about how the food was grown, was it having a lot of chemicals in it and other things, because the quality of the food grown is becoming lesser and lesser.
Yeah,
that's why people are moving into more like you said, the engineering and the manufactured food, which is in the form of tablets or in the form of impossible burgers and things like that, right? So
When you say tablets, it actually reminds me a similar kind of a thing. There's, I don't know how many people know about this, but there's something called as nootropics.
Yeah.
Nootropics is a grade of tablets which increases enhances your cognitive capabilities.
Ah.
You can think better, you can work longer, you can be more innovative, you can be more creative.
Mm-hmm.
Put it in a very, let's say... happy-go-lucky way, marijuana has the same effect. And incidentally, marijuana is getting engineered now into yeast. There's a beer company called Blue Moon, which is a very popular beer in US, in the Bay Area and other places. And the founder of it has figured a way out of producing yeast, which produces cannabis oil.
Wow.
So the yeast is now being used to, let us say, break down wheat, barley, a hop, which is the ingredients of beer, to have cannabis beer without the flavor of cannabis, without the smell of cannabis, but the effect of cannabis.
And not even growing cannabis.
And not even growing cannabis.
Yeah.
So the engineering aspect of it is extremely high.
Wow.
In that sense. But coming back to the same concept of nootropics, which gives you the high in terms of your thought capability or how you think and how you can work.
Hmm.
Nootropics is a field which has emerged in the last few years. People like Dave Asprey, who promote something called as bullet coffee, which is having certain kind of a butter in coffee and then drinking it.
Correct.
And stacking different types of chemicals.
Correct.
By the means of tablets,
mm-hmm.
can give you a much better cognitive capability and not have a side effect.
Mm-hmm.
So this is what people are actually experimenting. There's a very popular series in Netflix which is Limitless. Right? It's called the NZT pill.
NZT pill, yeah.
This is becoming a reality. It is not a far-fetched thing that in the next 4 or 5 years, you'll see people taking food supplements just to enhance cognitive capability. I mean, in the sports world, it's been there forever.
Yeah.
But in the you know, mental world of how you do things, it wasn't there. But now it's coming up completely.
From physical to cognitive, right?
Absolutely. So, and everything is getting engineered as we go.
Everything is engineered. Yeah, that's been the case. Yeah.
The entire concept of how we think about food is actually getting rewritten. Even large companies, say for example like Monsanto Seeds or Cargill or any of these guys, are rethinking food completely. They are involving data scientists to figure out what is the right optimum of, say for example, fertilizers that they can put in and get the right kind of nutrition, and at the same time, how do we engineer that food to grow faster, to be better, etc., etc.
When you say engineered, it's basically, you know, you're hacking. It's more like biohacking, and not your bio, but it's the plant's bio.
Plant's bio, or say for example, in the case of beer, it's the yeast bio.
Mm-hmm.
You see, today the flavor of beer comes because of how yeast ferments.
Correct.
Barley, hop, and
yeah.
But if you change the characteristics of yeast at a genetic level, then the flavor that you get is completely different. You can make, like we were discussing the other day, why don't we just pick up yeast and make a banana flavored beer out of it by the yeast giving out banana flavor from its genetic composition. So this is what is being tried out, and this is what is going to be tried out more and more.
Correct. Yeah.
But this is one part of engineering. The other part of engineering which is hitting, which you were kind of telling, was the 3D printed food.
Oh yeah. It was first printed by in Google, I guess, right? It was owned by Larry Ellison and the founders of Google.
Not Larry Ellison, Larry Page.
Larry Page.
Yeah.
Sorry, not Ellison. so it was... That was really interesting for me. I always thought 3D printing is in manufacturing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if I want to print my, you know, phone's back case, I'll print it on my own, right?
Yeah.
Because
that is
where my thoughts were limited into.
Yeah.
But I never thought a 3D printing possibility can occur in terms of we having food, and that has occurred, right? And then they also did a burger.
Yes.
And they 3D printed the burger, and the burger is no more there because it is already eaten by a lot of people, I guess. You know, it was cut into some multiple pieces, it was sold online and paid a lot of money for it, and then they ate it, right? So I think, you know, Your engineering food, your manufacturing food, your 3D printing your food.
Yeah.
Apart from, let's say, growing and having it in the current farm, you're doing all the other things possible to ensure that you get the right amount of nutrition to your body.
Well, I completely agree to it, but at the same time, I think a little differently.
Yeah.
That this is not something new.
Okay.
See, if you have seen how agriculture has worked for the last thousands of years, it's exactly that. You take the strain of one particular mango, you take the strain of another particular mango, put it together, and you get a new
flavor of it. Yeah,
so,
that's true. Yeah.
So, if you really look at it, engineering has been there for quite some time, I think it will continue, except that it is going at a much, much higher pace now. And we are not able to keep in pace with that. But very soon we are going to all be having engineered food in some sense or the other. We are already having it. We are going to be doing it a lot more now than what we have been doing before.
Exactly.
But
what's our viewers' opinion on having to try engineered food?
Yeah.
Manufactured in terms of any form?
Yeah.
And are we ready to say that, you know, I'm going to live healthy and nutritious by consuming the right amount
kind of
nutrition but I forget about the taste? So are we ready for such a you know, revolution which can probably happen?
Absolutely.
More and more come into, because then, you know, you will stop a lot of adultery and other things, like you said, you know, extra salt, extra sugar, everything gets stopped because you look for nutrition and not for taste.
Yes.
So hopefully there will be a new world. We will all be, you know, happy with the food which we eat and which we have engineered for our own bodies. I mean, imagine if now everyone starts engineering their own food, then it's like the most beautiful thing which can ever happen, right?
Yeah.
So it's the decentralized mechanism of, you know,
how food gets generated
and engineered at your home.
Yeah.
You have a certain thing which you want, and you only take that for what you require.
Required.
Right?
So exactly.
That would be a good world to see.
Yeah, let's see how it turns out. What is your opinion? Do let us know. And also let us know if there are any new different type of topics that you want us to cover.
Yeah.
Which we are not thinking about. We'd love to cover such topics. Yeah. So till next time then, back in the car 9 again. And very soon we'll be having the rest of the videos coming in. Some interesting ones coming in. We were just discussing about it. So let's see how it turns out to be. Yeah.
Sure. Okay. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thanks. Bye-bye.